one, brought to you by the Holy Cross Track and Field Team. My name is Lisa, and I'll be your instructor for the day. First thing you need to know about pole vaulting is your weight, because your pole completely rests on your weight. So, I weigh a whopping 115. I move up to the next pole. This is a 120. It will support my weight as I fly through the air over those standards. Now, the first thing you need to know about your pole is how to grip it. So, you go to the very top of the pole with your left hand, as high as you can go, slide it into your armpit, and that is shoulder width apart. That's a perfect form to vault with. Now, moving on, we'll talk bounding. Bounding is a perfect simulation. Bounding is a perfect simulation of what it really feels like to fly through the air. Watch. See? Now, if I was really doing the proper technique, I'd be vaulting into a pit, such as that.
The pit,
as you can see, is extremely durable. You wouldn't get hurt when falling so far from the air. Now, the bungee cord is totally used to prepare jumpers to move up to the bar. The bar is a horizontal piece of metal designed to test the abilities of vaulters and see how high they can go. Bungee is an extremely good training tool. It's a very good transition tool.
Who didn't get one?
Yeah, Will Grogan. Will Grogan is a member of the Holy Cross.
Where was he when we were stretching?
I was with
this person. He's a board member and has contributed greatly in the past 4 years. Will is now in his junior year in the track and field and is working very hard on his triceps, biceps, and biceps.
You know he's coming.
Junior members of the team include myself and Colin Campbell. And Brian Budick, veteran of the team. Not ready for it. Never ready.
Shaking cold, these hands are meant to hold.
Think you'll be. Move along like I know you do.
And even when your hope is gone, move along, just to make it through.